It's easy to install the communication hardware on your smart water heater. Okay, let's get started. Before you begin, you will need an installed water heater, two screwdrivers, both cross and flathead, the port adapter made by A. O. Smith, the communication module made by eRadio. Both are supplied by your utility, and some strong tape. You will also need your computer, tablet, or smartphone, and your home Wi-Fi network name and password. The process consists of three simple steps. Step 1. Installation of the communication hardware. Step 2. Connecting to Wi-Fi. And Step 3. Adjusting the antenna, if necessary. First, let's attach the hardware. If the plumber has already installed the adapter and communication module, proceed to Step 2. Start by turning off the power to the water heater at the main panel breaker. Remove the plastic cover plate to expose the communication port. It is located either on top of the water heater or just above the LCD display near the top of the tank. Insert the port adapter into the rectangular multi-pin port and screw the two screws down tight. Remove the receptacle cover from the port adapter and insert the eRadio communication module into the adapter and screw the two screws down tight. Next, turn the power back on to the water heater at the breaker. To connect to Wi-Fi, use a laptop, tablet, or smartphone to scan for the eRadio Wi-Fi access point and connect to it as you would any Wi-Fi hub. The Wi-Fi name is ER_ADIO, and your password is 123456-7890. Now, open a web browser and go to this URL, 192.168.1.1/, and press Enter. You should see an eRadio web page. Click Scan for Wi-Fi Networks, then select your home network. If your Wi-Fi network is protected, you have to enter your password 2 times, then click Next. On the following page, click Save and Apply. Once the Wi-Fi setup is done, it's time for a 5-minute break while the system completes the connection. Look for the small green light on the communication module. If the module is receiving a strong FM radio signal, it will blink several times a second. If you observe the yellow light blinking in a repeating pattern, please contact your utility for support. If the green light is blinking fast, you're done. If not, move the antenna wire to another position, about 1/8 of a full revolution, and tape the wire fully extended for 10 seconds against the tank, wall, or ceiling. Extending the wire to the ceiling, wall, or other non-metallic surface is preferred, and see if the green light blinks faster. If not, move another 1/8 turn either clockwise or counterclockwise and repeat these steps until a position is found that produces the fastest blinking green light. Then tape the antenna down to assure that it will not move for the duration of the pilot. That's it. You're done. Your utility will email you indicating successful installation.